When there is nothing left but love. Chapter 6. Rebecca is pregnant. Miss Larson, I am surprised at how fast you've switched personalities. Casting her a cursory glance, I picked up my bag and prepared to make my journey to the Fuller's home. Since Ashton was unwilling to go, it was my job to go in his stead. As soon as I reached the door, Rebecca stepped forward to block my way. Seeing that Ashton was absent, she could finally take a breather from pretending to be a harmless little bunny. She questioned me sharply. When are you going to sign the divorce papers? I was stunned for a second. Nevertheless, I released a chuckle as I looked at her. Are you playing the homewrecker by forcing me to divorce him? Joyread the homewrecker. Calling her that seemed to have hit a nerve because her face darkened as she snarled. If it weren't for you, the lady of this house would have been me by now. Since George has died, there is no one to protect you. No one who will ensure that you can continue living here. If I were you, I'd sign the divorce papers. Take the money that Ashton has offered. And get as far away from here as possible. Well, it's a pity that Joyread not me. Miss Larson, I retorted coldly as I ignored her jabs and skirted around her to go downstairs. Other than Ashton, no one in the world could say anything to hurt me. Being a person who had always basked in the limelight, Rebecca felt dissatisfied that I was ignoring her. She suddenly gave a hard grip on my arm. How shameless can you get? Scarlett, Ash doesn't even like you. So what's the use of clinging onto him? Glancing back at her, I had the urge to laugh, but my next words were uttered calmly. Since you're aware of his stance toward me, what's there to be nervous about? You. She flushed a bright red, unable to respond. I leaned closer to her with a faint sneer on my lips and lowered my voice into a whisper. As for why I am clinging onto him, I paused as I evened out my tone. He has got some mad skills. So you tell me. What's the use of it? Joyread so shameless. Rebecca's eyes reddened with anger. Without thinking, she raised her hands and intended to push me. The stairs were behind me. So out of instinct, I twisted sideways to avoid getting pushed by her. Nonetheless, I never expected her to lose her own footing. She fell right down the stairs. Ahhhh. Her ear-splitting scream resounded throughout the living room. And I stood rooted to the ground for a while, unable to react. To my misfortune, I was shoved aside just as I sensed a frosty front darting my way. Then, Ashton's figure shot down the stairs as he went to check on Rebecca, who was already lying at the bottom of the stairs. Rebecca was curled into a ball on the floor, holding her abdomen with an agonized look on her ashen face. She spoke in a feeble voice. My child. My child. There was blood pooling beneath her body, staining a large area of the carpet red. Every fiber in my body froze. She is pregnant. With Ashton's child. Ash. The child. The child. Rebecca tugged at Ashton's sleeve as she repeated the words like a broken record. Beads of sweat covered Ashton's forehead. His icy expression sank with dread. Don't be afraid. The child will be fine. He comforted Rebecca and scooped her into his arms before he strode toward the door. After taking a few steps forward, Ashton stopped abruptly. His glowering eyes were as dark as an abyss. And the anger in his voice was palpable. I bet that you're happy, Scarlett. His simple words were full of hatred and fury. I was bereft of speech. I did not know how to react. Aren't you going after them to explain? A deep voice came from behind, jolting me into action. I turned and was stunned to see Joyread there all of a sudden. Suppressing the panic that was rising in my heart, I calmly asked, explain what? He raised his brows. Aren't you afraid that he would think that you pushed Rebecca? My eyes dipped down as a hint of bitterness shone through them. It doesn't matter whether I pushed her. The truth is that Rebecca is hurt and someone has to take the blame for it. It's good that you know. Joyread descended the stairs as he left the villa with his medical kit in hand. He was probably heading off to the hospital to see Rebecca. Welcome to download Joyread app to read more chapters of When There Is Nothing Left But Love novel online.